Hello, my two not fatties vlogger on my channel. I'm Jacob from Jacob's Books Corner, and today for September 6th, I ended up reading a whole bunch of books, and I'm just gonna tell you the books I'm about to get into in this very, hopefully, not as long, because I'm gonna redo this intro, which was the longest part, and I'm just gonna tell you the books I didn't end up reading. Just know, that's better. I won't tell you. You have to watch to find out. Just know that I read 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 books in this video, which I adored almost all of them, and yeah. And if you guys are curious to see what they are, just continue to watch. It's like a makeshift 24-hour readathon, kind of. Even though I did it probably, it's more like a 12-hour readathon. I read some books in 12 hours. Don't you say goodbye. Hello, I want to come in here. It's about 2 o'clock. And I finished my first book of the day, which is On a Sunbeam by Tilly Walden. Now, I know this seems like it's 2 o'clock, Jacob. I also kind of slept in a lot later because I was really tired and I kept going back to sleep, which I think is perfectly fine. This is one of my days off from work. So, you know, I'm reading for fun. But On a Sunbeam follows a girl as she is shipped off from her boarding school in space to a reconstruction team in space. And it's about her journey and stuff under those lines, with a very heavy romance throughout the whole entire thing. And it's centered between these two girls that fall in love, whatever. The representation here was phenomenal. I just found it to be very confusing, a little hard to follow. And a lot of the places are just so out of there that under, like, you just don't really know what's going on. So I gave it 3.5 for that reason. But I would recommend it if you guys are curious. I'm always recommending more and more gay graphic novels and stuff as I find them, as I have found abundance of them. I'm pretty sure every single one we're going to be reading today has some type of queer representation in it, which, you know, I'm obsessed with. So that's that one. I'm going to go work on some stuff and then possibly read my audiobook. If so, I'll talk about it when I do. And maybe that'll be my second book I get done. And then we're going to pick up a poetry collection for my second or third as well. So I'm very excited about it. I don't know what poetry collection yet, though. I'll tell you guys when I do. Okay, so it is extremely much later. It's like 8 o'clock. Maybe it's 9 o'clock now. I don't think it's 9 o'clock. I think it's probably 8 o'clock. That makes more sense to me. I'm still sitting down. We're reading. I have a whole stack here, but I read 2 books. Actually, I finished 3 books since the last time I talked to you. So let's do a little bit of a wrap up. I ended up finishing My Heart Chainsaw by Stephen Grant Jones. I gave this a 4.5 out of 5 stars. I think the gory slashing ending really did help sell this book to me personally. I also did not see the twist coming. I don't know. In my wrap up for this quarter, and also my wrap up, I'll talk more about trigger warnings and stuff, but specifically for this video, I would maybe look them up, as there's some really graphic things that I didn't really realize were gonna be in the book until afterwards, not including the graphic nature of the gory violence and the ammo abuse, which is pretty second nature to Stephen Graham Jones's works now, at least all the ones I read. So that seems more like a given to me. If you've never read him before, then it's more shocking. But because I have read several of his books, that was very much a given. There's a few other things, a few other lines he decides to cross that I found to be more shocking than that. Then I did end up finishing White Blood, A Lyrics of Virginia by Kiki Pironi. I think it's how you pronounce it. I just ended up finishing this right as we speak. So that's next, because it's really fresh in my mind. I want to talk about this one. Hit me really hard, really, really hard. You know, it's one of those things of where you're in present time, but you also jump back into past and you go through all these different stories of free slaves and non-free slaves and what this meant to this state, how this happened with this state, what the amendments actually meant, and this thing or this thing. And it's told in such a beautifully lyric way. I have a hard time, I think everybody should, because it's really disturbing what white people did to anybody, you know? Like, and this one really just really hit me really hard. There's a few in here that are gonna stick with me for a long time. A few in here, you know, this was a 5 for me, obviously. Anything else? No. And then I also picked up Best of Me by Nicholas Sparks, which was not on my original TBR at all. But I was like, what is a book I could really, really fast that I definitely know I can finish? And it's been like 5 or 6 hours since I've talked to you. And so I picked up The Best of Me. I wanted to read a physical book in here as well, as I have a lot of graphic novels and that type of thing. And so, I don't know. Here we are. This follows, I should know this, but you're going to find out in all this book, Amanda and Dawson, as they jump back and forth between their younger selves and their older selves, right? Because there isn't a, is there a second? Yeah. The younger self and older selves. This is one of Nicholas Sparks' darker stories. So if you're looking for like more like grittier, deeper story for Nicholas Sparks, like do recommend. And it's because it takes place in like horrible territories of North Carolina where drug deals and stuff go on. That's basically what makes this darker, is because there's actual violence on the page that's not taking place in a war zone. There is a little bit of war zoning stuff in here, but that's just because it's Nicholas Sparks' formula. Amanda was a fine character. I didn't mind her as most of the other protagonists I have read from him, and I find most of them very insufferable and very unrealistic. Amanda was okay, not great, but she was fine. Dawson, on the other hand, was also another one of those clunky jocks that kind of pisses me off. I really like Dawson 25 years later, and I do find the ending to be very tragic for that specific reason. I also found it to be kind of cliched, so it was both annoying but also tragic, you know what I mean? So yeah, I gave this a 2.5 out of 5 stars. It's probably more like a 3. I'm gonna give it a 3 out of 5 stars. Yeah, that I've said on it. But yeah, so I read this one. Very exciting. We are moving on to Witch Boy by Molly Knox Ostenberg. Is the next book I'm picking up, so I'll update you guys when I read a few more. Oh, I'm also 30 pages into This Is How We End Time War. I have no opinions on that yet, so once I have one, I'll tell you. If I have one, who knows? I don't think it's confusing, so. Oh god, we've fallen. Okay. Okay, so the original plan was to stop here and go over to my desk, because I really do want to finish my bullet journal. I just don't think we're going to finish it today, ironically. But that's because I decided I want to get more books read than I do wanting to focus on just one book, because I am listening to my next audiobook, which is relatively short, and if I would have prioritized it a little bit earlier and finished my other audiobook earlier, could have totally read it today. It's just probably not going to happen. I have a feeling I'll probably finish it tomorrow. Currently, we're in the middle of Angel and Hannah, which I'm very much liking. It's very interesting, and it's reminding me of a lot of other stories I've read, which I really like. But I have like 6 or 7 other books here that I know I can definitely get to before midnight. And so I'm gonna focus my time over there instead of focusing my time on one book, because I'd rather get to 2, like 4 or 5 more books than one more book, you know what I mean? I'll update you guys. I wanted to give you guys a little bit of update on that. I'll update you guys a little bit later when I'm a little bit further into another. Hello, I'm coming in here to outro you guys. I did finish 2, actually I don't remember where I finished off with. We're just gonna run through them all, you know? Let's start with the first one. And also, by the way, in case you're curious, this is how many pages I read over this day. I don't know, I'll do the math, but this is how many pages I read. But yeah, okay. So the first book I'm talking about is My Heart is a Chainsaw by Stephen Graham Jones. I ended up giving this a 4.5 out of 5 stars. We're gonna do a run through, a quick fire rate of the ones I've talked about, the ones I have not talked about, I will put a little more extra thought into. We also read On a Sunbeam by Tilly Walden, which I gave a 3.5 out of 5 stars. Which, by the way, that's very rare for that book, supposedly. So if you think you're gonna like it, pick it up. And then I read Buffy the Vampire Slayer Volume 3, which I gave a 4 stars because of that man right there. All the scenes with Dracula and Xander make it a 4. I read novellas just because of them. Then I read, actually this is no particular order, but on my list, Angel and Hannah, which I really want to talk about for a second. This is written by Yushi Yi Park. There is a poem in here that was so heartbreakingly beautifully raw that it broke me in the best way possible. I adored this book so much. It also didn't go down the route that I thought it would go down. This was a much more realistic portrayal of a Romeo and Juliet retelling, to the point where I feel like the purists are gonna get pissed, but the non-purists might enjoy. So figure out where you're on that line, and this might be for you, I don't know. I really liked the poetry that was in here. I really enjoyed a lot of different things. I really enjoyed different ways the story was told. And so yeah, I really liked this. I really, really enjoyed it. I gave it a 4 out of 5 stars. It was not perfect. Like I said, I think I'm a little bit more of a purist than what this wanted me to be, but I really liked the heritage. I really liked the culture. I also really, really enjoyed how raw and how honest it was. So if you're interested in this book, or you have no idea what it's about, it's about Angel and Hannah. I've talked about it. Actually, I didn't give it, since I cut out my intro, there is no. This one, oh my god. Oh, but we talked about the other ones, okay. Angel and Hannah, it follows, I'm just gonna read you the little thing. Hannah is a Korean-American girl from Queens, New York, and Angel is a Puerto Rican boy from Brooklyn, falling in love in the spring of 1993 at a quinceañera, and it's about their life together kind of thing, which you know I'm a sucker for. It's over a very big course of time. Then I read Witch Boy by Molly Knox Osberg. This is about Aiden, and he really wants to be a witch, but in his culture specifically, they have to be, boys become demon hunters, girls become witches. It's very much what it sounds like. If you're trying to figure out, ooh, what's the message here? It's very much what it sounds like. Aiden wants to be a witch. Yeah, it's very much. I really liked it for the message. I really liked it because of the story. I really liked it because of the things it was putting down. And yeah, if you're interested in it, I'm really going to pick up. I do plan on picking up the rest of the series, as I do know this is like book one, if I'm not mistaken. And I really liked it. I really liked her writing. Here again. Their writing? I don't know. I need to start using that pronoun. Then, of course, I read Nicholas Sparks, The Best of Me. Like I said, this follows Amanda and Noah. Noah? Is that you? Noah? Dawson? Dawson? Amanda and Dawson, as they fall in love both 25 years in the past and 25 years in the future. Dawson grows up from a very, very horrible family. Amanda grows up from his white-collar family. And it's about their love story. You know how it goes. It's a Nicholas Sparks thing. You recommend it because you read The Notebook. Guess what? The Notebook was better. It's also shorter, which makes it a lot better. Nicholas Sparks works really well with short mediums, which is why it scares me when I find Nicholas Sparks books that are like 600 pages long. It's like, honey, you cannot write that. This is fine. It was fine. I'm kind of excited to watch the movie because it's been so long since I've seen it. So yeah, a perk of rereading Nicholas Sparks book. Then I read Light Blood, A Lyric of Virginia by Keith Pesentro, which I've already talked about before. This one really touched me. This was a 5 out of 5 stars. I highly recommend this book. It's hard to get through, hard to read, but I highly, highly recommend. All right, and those are the 7 books I read in this video. I hope you guys enjoyed. But that being said, goodbye.